The story of Elvis on Tour, the movie, and now the box set is originally, it could have been a record and a film. So we came up with the idea of including the Blu-ray in there, which gives you the pleasure of watching it and also the opportunity to not watch, but just play. By the spring of 1972, Elvis was at the peak of his career. He was just out of a recording studio. The band had never played better, it never sung better, and everywhere was a sellout.
What's amazing about Elvis and getting to work on a lot of these Elvis projects is he started in the 50s at the birth of rock and roll. As music changed and as rock and roll kind of changed, he somewhat stayed the same, but then he veered off into the bigger productions and obviously the live shows to kind of be a sonic archaeologist. It's a really nice deep dive into just a certain time of his life. That time period, there wasn't a computer, there wasn't an undo button, there wasn't a save, so they would have to record it where it sounded finished as best they could as they recorded it.
Always on my mind. This is a rehearsal made for the movie as a pretend recording session, and Elvis just recorded it. Obviously, this is not the record that we listened to, but it's damn close.
Yeah, it sounds really good.
We keep the rehearsals when we can find them, in that they show a lighthearted, playful Elvis. The fun thing with Elvis studio recordings is they ran the tape. That leaves us often with interesting alternate versions of songs from the recording sessions, and that's a great kick.
I try to do the technical stuff first, which is EQing and finding the things, and then I try to remove the technical aspect out of mixing and just get to the emotional, like what moves me more, turning up the guitar here, the piano here, the vocal here.
We actually have three concerts that have never been released that between Matt and I we put together, and Matt has pulled out little details that you would never hear before.
The vocal is the most important part, so I get the track to feel good, I get the vocal in, because I want the certain words of each song to really jump out and hit you. And when I get the vocal right, I ride the instruments around the vocal. So Elvis's voice is always interacting with the music, but it's always the forefront. We're not trying to beat the original mix or master of an Elvis recording. We're just trying to show you, with today's technology, more insight into it and more magnifying glass on moments of Elvis. The goal is to make you feel like you were at the concert with that, as opposed to just a controlled listening environment.
Matt, did you do American Trilogy?
Yeah.
Elvis really loved that song.
Let's see, this should be it.
He was in total control of it. He did what he wanted to do, selected the songs himself. He'd chosen his own band. And if he wanted to change a song during the show, he did, and everybody followed.
It's an incredible, interesting deep dive into a really unique part of Elvis's life. And it really shows you like a great insight into what touring is like and the madness that would have been like to have been Elvis.
By 1972, the Elvis band was as good as it could ever get. People had given up arguing whether he was the king of rock and roll. He was the king, and nobody disputed that.